Hi everybody, it's Peter here from Triple G Comics, your Ginger Geordie Geek. Welcome back. So, a couple of unboxings for you today. A couple of boxes I picked up off the internet, which have got us quite excited because it's got Moon Knight issue ones in, which I think look absolutely stunning. I'll show you them in a minute. If I can just encourage you all to please like and subscribe to the videos if you like my content. And don't forget, each month we give away 20 free comic books. All you have to do is like, subscribe and comment on previous month's videos, and I'll select someone at random at the start of each month. That's open to everybody, open to UK, and I'll also ship to our watchers in America. Good evening, America. Right, so cracking on. This is a box I've picked up off Tinternet. One of my favourite Facebook groups, Low Grade Collectors UK, John Marston, put a picture of a Moon Knight book up that he purchased. That's proper. He purchased a book. So he purchased this book and said that you can only get it as part of this epic box from Limited Edition. I'll be honest with you, I hadn't heard of Limited Edition before. So I went onto Facebook and had a little bit of a look at their stuff. I put a link up above and then went onto eBay to see what they had, and they had this epic box. All the boxes come with the same comics in, but there is a chance to get exclusives and signed books and all that kind of jazz. Really like the look of them. Had a little unboxing of a similar one to this, which is behind us here, and loved it, so I ordered another one straight away. So I've got two of these now, but I love them. So this one is a bit of a mystery because I don't know what's in it. The t'other one, I'll show you that one first. So this is the one I've already opened, and this came with a stunning t-shirt, which I've already given to my son because he likes that kind of stuff, from Architect Conduit. You get a badge. I'll put a picture of these all up for you to have a look at, and then you get some books. So in this particular box I got the Architect and the Conduit book. I've not read it. I'll have a read and see what I think of that. But I also got, and I was very pleased with this, a copy of this book, signed by the artist. Now I can't remember. I started doing this video and I can't even remember what the book is. I did write it down. Anyway, so I got a copy of that, signed by the artist. I remember looking at it and going online and thinking, wow, that's a good book, and great to have the signature. So I will get that one sent off to Hobgoblin's Hideaway. The main reason I bought the book, the box even, which way does that go then? The main reason I bought the box is for this absolutely tremendous Moon Knight cover. Absolutely stunning. And this apparently is the only place you can get the colour version of this absolutely amazing artwork. So I love that. Absolutely love it. So thank you, John, for pointing us in the right direction for that one. So this box came through the post today. Like I say, opened that box the other day, loved it. So then I ordered another one, and I've just started unwrapping it. So inside, it's always very well packaged. Now this should be the same box other than that signed book. That's a kind of a special I got. But another badge. The books are inside the t-shirt. So I'll just unwrap the t-shirt for you. Oh, there's another sticker. Just found a sticker on the floor. That's rather nice. That's the t-shirt. Don't even know what I'm doing here. So that's the t-shirt. Nice big size, that one, so that'll be for me. Smaller one went to my son, obviously. The books, we've got another copy of that superb Moon Knight cover, which I absolutely love. So that's two copies of that. Another copy of the Architect and the Conduit number one. And another copy of that book that I don't know what it is, signed So, two signed copies of that, so I'm over the moon, and they're in both really good condition. I like that. I like that a lot. Excellent. Pleased with those. What we got here? Oh, nice. Yeah. So, over on the Killer Comic Show, link up above, go and check it out. There's a guy called Andy who does indie picks. Now, Andy is responsible for me moving away from Marvel, I have to say. And he's getting us into some more indie books, I guess you would say. So things like Nice House on the Lake and all that kind of stuff. Even though that's DC, isn't it? Is Nice House on the Lake DC, technically? Black Label? I'm not sure. Anyway, he got us into this Basilisk. Read the first issue, which this is the first issue, second print. Read the first issue and I thought, oh, it's all right. I wasn't blown away by it, but it's getting better and better with every issue, and I absolutely love it now. I think we're up to issue four or something like that, and it's brilliant. Really enjoyed it. I've already got a copy or two of Basilisk One, so why have I picked up this one? Well, this is the second print, and within this second print, there's a couple of pages of the House of Slaughter. So technically, this is the first appearance of House of Slaughter. If you go into that kind of stuff. So I picked that one up just for the spec on it, really, and also because I love the book. And I'm hoping to get some of these signed if is Cullen that? I can't remember if Cullen's at Thought Bubble or not. But yeah, lovely books, really worth picking up. Great story. And like I say, stick with it. First issue is okay, but it gets better after that, I think. All right. So this is from another box from Slab City Comics, great online seller. Ah, right, I like it. So, Free Comic Day happened recently, and my local comic shops didn't do it because they didn't have the stock. So it's going to be, I believe, tomorrow actually. Well, it'll not be tomorrow when this video goes out. Think of it a bit like Back to the Future. When this video goes out, it'll have already happened. All right? Okay. So, but when it was supposed to be Comic Book Day, they didn't have anything in. And I was very keen to get a copy of Enter the House of Slaughter. And I know the Slab City Comics were doing an offer where they would give you a copy with every order that you placed. So I placed an order, and I'm very pleased to say that they have sent me a very nice copy of the house, sorry, Enter the House of Slaughter, which I shall go straight away and stick in a comic bag. And they've also not stamped the book, so that's tremendous. So very, very happy with that. Lovely looking book. Very pleased with that. I'm going to put that one to one side because I'm going to stick it straight in the bag. Now, what I ordered to get that, I mean, I've got a lot of copies of this now, if I'm being really honest with you, but I just love the series, and I also think it's got to be primed, I think, for either a movie or a TV series. I've literally just mentioned it, but it's two variant copies of The Nice House on the Lake number one, so pink version and the blue version, and that's a beautiful cover. I really, really do like that cover, the skeletons dragging the character down. Lovely. So nice books. Now, I do think that the writer, James Tynion, is at Thought Bubble, so I will be taking those and getting them signed, and then they will be going straight away to my good friend Tim at the Hobgoblin's Hideaway. We've got a Forbidden Planet box, which I haven't unwrapped yet. Forbidden Planet's always an interesting one. Never quite sure what the quality of the books are going to be like when you get them. So I'd be interested to see. They're all bagged and boarded, which is a bonus for FP. So noticed again someone on sorry, just got confused for a second. Somebody on Facebook mentioned that these were back in stock and they were very, very cheap. I've heard the story is absolutely atrocious, but there we are. But these are two signed copies of Mum, Mother of Madness, signed by Emily Clarke, who is obviously Callisto from the Game of Thrones series. I have no idea what this is about. I picked it up just because it's a signed book, and I'm into my signed books at the moment. I have to say, the books themselves look pretty good. No dinged corners or anything that I can immediately see, which was nice. Yeah, okay. So two signed copies of Mother of Madness. I only pay like £20 each of them. Now I think that's pretty good value for a good signed book. But what else did I get? It's a bit of a theme to this video. And this is the bit that confused us because I thought that was a double-sided thing, but it's not, it's two books. So this is Nice House on the Lake. Again, it's another variant cover. I've got the standard cover. I haven't got a clue what this is. I have got a clue. I know it's the Nice House on the Lake, but I don't understand what the two books are. I can't remember what I ordered because they look like the same book. Bear with us. What we got? What? Frankie's Comics exclusive. Frankie's Comics exclusive. I'm not sure. Is one meant to be a variant? One's. I don't know what the. I mean, I can obviously see that the title. I wonder if this is meant to be a virgin or something. I don't know. I don't know what I've done there. I've ordered two nice books anyway, haven't I? So two more Nice House on the Lakes. That takes us up to a fair few copies of Nice House on the Lake now. I'm probably just going to have to stop buying them. Getting a little bit obsessive. Okay, always love it when I get a nice flimsy envelope. So what have I got in here? Okay, so this is Special Marvel Edition, The Hands of Shang-Chi, Master of Kung Fu, number 16. So second appearance of Shang-Chi and first appearance of Midnight. Lovely condition, really nice book. Very pleased with that. Very, very pleased with that. It's a beaut. It's a beaut. Nice book. Finally, and I'm looking forward to opening this one, and I haven't taken the tape off yet because it's literally just come through. There's another tremendous YouTube channel called Dawn of Comics. I'll put the link up above. Dawn of Comics is really entertaining, really worth going back and having a look. He does some tremendous What's in the Box videos. He's also a member of the Nerd Herd, so reviews the books on there. And every now and then he does a comic book quiz. So there's a link to his latest quiz just up ahead there. Now, this comic quiz is absolutely tremendous. I've watched it a number of times. I was lucky enough to be invited on a couple of weeks ago, and Shane does an absolutely tremendous job. He puts a hell of a lot of time, effort, and hard work into running the quiz. So took part, had a great laugh. Great bunch of guys, and I met some new people, people I hadn't seen before, and people's channels I've never heard of before. So I checked them out straight away and subscribed, and it was just good fun. So, and of course, you know, and you know, people who watch this channel would expect nothing else, I guess. But of course, I took part and absolutely bossed it. Do you know what I mean? It was ridiculous, to be fair. There was no one close, really, if I'm honest with you. In fact, it was too easy, if I'm being quite frank. And of course, like I say, I won, as you would expect. And of course, I am a Geordie, so had I not won, I would have proper kicked off. So it's probably best for everybody that I did win. So what am I getting? I like that. Shane sent us a nice little note saying thank you for joining. The best thing in the world here is this. This is the official certificate. This is awarded Triple G for trying their best but not winning Dawn of Comics. What are you on about? I did win. What's he playing at there? Shane, I hope this is a joke. Triple G for trying their best but not winning the Dawn of Quiz Night. I will kick off big style, mind. I won. What we got in here? So, excellent. We've got the Elasticator, number one. So at the end of the quiz, basically, you get to pick your prize. All right. So I obviously, there's kind of themed bags. So I picked one that said something about stretching. I thought it was quite rude, actually. It was a little bit smutty. And it was basically a series called Elasticator Issues 1 to 4, which is a series I've not heard of and I've not read. So I'm very, very pleased to win them. Over the moon with that. Now, what I'm going to do with this certificate, Shane, is I'm not going to tell you that you've sent us the wrong certificate, and I'm going to wait until we're next on the quiz, and I'm basically going to take you to task for it. All right? So I'm looking forward to that now. So I'll be winding you up something rotten in the future. Okie doke. So that's everything, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Some great books there. Thanks for joining, and I'll catch you next time. Take care now. Bye-bye.